Let us take this example. Solve x cube minus 9x square plus 27x minus 27 is equal to 0, and cyclically x, y and z are replaced. These three simultaneous equations with three unknowns x, y and z should be solvable. So as to solve them, let us first observe that these coefficients are good, and therefore we add all the three equations to get complete cubes, x minus 3 bracket cube, y minus 3 bracket cube and z minus 3 bracket cube. Addition of all these three bracket cubes must be equal to 0. So by looking at this equation, we realize that x is equal to y is equal to z is equal to 3 is definitely a solution. But now we need to find out whether there are a few more solutions available to this system of equations. So we'll have to consider the cases. But before that, let us rewrite these equations. Say for example, y cube minus 27 is equal to 9x square minus 27x. This implies y minus 3 into y square plus 3y plus 9 is equal to 9x minus x minus 3. This is simple factorization. Now, what we come to know from this factorization is that this bracket is going to be always positive for every value of y because its discriminant is less than 0. So, 9 is always positive. Therefore, LHS, parity of LHS and parity of RHS will be controlled by values of x and y, and therefore, we will have further discussion on that. But before that, the way we have factorized the first equation, we have factorized the second and third, we call them 5, 6 and 7 for further use. Now the case is if x is greater than 0, if x is greater than 3, then if I put x is greater than 3, then this bracket is positive, this x is also positive, and therefore RHS is positive, therefore LHS must be positive, and hence y must be greater than 3. So if I use y is greater than 3 in equation 6, again, same logic can be applied that this bracket is positive, this is positive, therefore RHS is positive, and hence LHS must be positive, hence Z must be greater than 3. So if I end up having X greater than 3, I end up having Y greater than 3 and Z greater than 3. Therefore, all the 3 X, Ys and Zs are greater than 3, which means this LHS cannot be equal to 0, therefore contradiction to 6. Case 2, if X is less than 0, by 5, if x is less than 0, by 5, this is less than 0 and this is also less than 0. Therefore, RHS is still positive. And if RHS is still positive, then y minus 3 must be positive and hence y must be greater than 3. If y is greater than 3, then z is greater than 3. And by 7, if I put z is greater than 3 over here, I get x is greater than 3, which means I assumed x is less than 0 and I got x greater than 3 contradiction. Therefore, none of them can be less than 0. Case number 3, if x is between 0 and 3. So if x is between 0 and 3, that means LHS is negative. If LHS is negative, then y value can be either less than 0 or between 0 to 3, but we have said y cannot be less than 0. Therefore, y also must be between 0 to 3. If I use this condition for equation number 6, then I am getting z also must be less than, must be between 0 and 3. It cannot be less than 0 because we have proved it here. So, if all the three equations are simultaneously true, then all the three brackets in equation number 4 are negative and their cubes are also going to be negative, therefore LHS is going to be negative, and hence this is contradiction to equation numbers 4. So all the three cases determine that x is equal to y is equal to z is equal to 3 is the only solution for this simultaneous equations. Thank you.